sería.
Wasting any time, are you?
Your little rampage is going to attract attention. Attention from people I don't care to associate with.
Yeah, imagine not.
Thankfully, closing off your loose ends is as simple as tossing around some super grade. With any luck, this will keep them off my ass. For a little while, anyway. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. There's still the matter of killing Georgie and Sal. You should get a kick out of hearing this.
Who'd you send?
Oh, I did it myself.
Ear to ear, just like you want.
Any sign of DeGommel?
No. He's gone. I look everywhere. It's like he never even fucking existed.
I am leveraged out the ass. Called in every favor, and none of it made a goddamn difference. We're fucked. I am fucked.
Oh, now that's bullshit. We still got some men. I say we hit the streets. We're gonna find that cocksucker.
Every lowlife ball of piss in this city smells blood in the water. My blood. You understand? And they step over their own mother if it meant being the one to clip me. I wouldn't last 10 minutes out there.
Don't let them come in here and fuck us. There's got to be something we can do.
You call up whatever men we still have left. You tell them to meet us up there at the casino. And when Lincoln Clay shows up, we'll do everything we can to plant that goddamn nigga in the ground right next to us. That's what we can do. Go on, get the fuck out of here. Go! God damn it!
Should have known that Marcano would go to ground at the casino.
You can take the bridge up there, so it's a straight shot.
You know, none of this would have happened without you.
It's either this or right away in some goddamn office. And once you've killed those assholes, you come and find me. I'll be hanging around over at the Padres.
You got it.
You give them hell, champ.
Goddamn copyright music. It's so appropriate, though, for this moment. Crazy time effects! We are going to the casino. That's the casino? Oh, yeah! I recognize it. Alright, we're here. Crashed our way in.
What the fuck? Kill him!
Say goodbye, motherfucker.
Take my big gun.
Grenade going out.
This is the perfect weapon for the last boss. The last fight with Marcano.
There you are.
Find Georgie.
Gotta get behind something.
You. Come on. So I can't run with this gun. Too heavy.
Damn, that hurts.
Yeah, it does.
Nice dibs on this fucker. Get me out of here. Spotted one, boys.
Oh yeah, mowing down the enemies.
Too late to run there.
No mercy for you. Dead. 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 Dead.
Let's go.
Oh, this gun.
Downstairs handle this. It's what they're getting paid for. I ain't come here to watch someone else do all the work. I came here to bury that cocksucker, just like we said.
You ain't that fly, dipshit.
I ain't the one.
Oh, we've got massive beef with Georgie. He's the one that killed us. What's up here? Nothing. Nothing is up here. I'm coming. Georgie, I'm coming. Ooh, fancy car. Look at that. Paradiso. Look at that. They have no clue. No idea what's about to happen here. Huh? Sup, boys! Boom, boom, boom! Raise the fucking... Oh, grenade. Hey, 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 hey. Got three left. Oh, Georgie, I'm coming to you. Don't you worry, don't you worry. Dead. How is he not dead yet? Rose one.
Shithead, hit me! Come tussle with a motherfucker your own size.
Uh-oh, I'm running out of ammo. Oh! Wow. That's right, you're empty. Oh, what the fuck? Where are they coming from? Alright, I got the pistol left. Still got some grenade left.
A fucking grenade!
Ooh. Medic cabinet's just right there. Use it!
First cut's mine.
Run for cover! Get some ammo! This, the Riot 550. That's a really good shotgun. There we go, got some ammo.
First cut's mine.
There we go.
Whoa, there he is!
First cut's mine.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
Run. That's not gonna leave. Getting under cover.
Grenade! They're dead. Oh, that's Georgie! You're fucked, mate. That's it. There's no more ammo.
You stupid motherfucker.
I always thought you were my friend. That you had me and Ellis's backs. It was just an act. You didn't kill me because I said no. You killed me because you thought you owned me. Owned all of us.
It was never about us. It was about my old man. My father. I'd do anything for him. Same as you and Sammy.
And you understand why I have to do this.
Oh, but that is... That's brutal. Makano's next.
I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln, but you're not. And you never will be.
Confront Makano. What? Can't take our guns out. He's all by himself. Oh. I smell a cutscene.
Hell of a sight, ain't it? When I first come to this town, it was nothing more than a backwater shithole. Now look at it.
Let me see your hands.
Whatever was between us is over, you understand? It ended the second it was you coming up them stairs instead of my son. You want a drink?
All right.
Had this imported from Scotland. Single malt. Usually I'm a bourbon man, but I figured I'd order something with a little more class for when the casino opened. Not much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Don't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer Shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucho died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. A giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. Then there was another one where cottonmouths biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was Georgie's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucho's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. And all of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the men sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
I would imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
And then this was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people, more than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes, sir. Here we are.
son is dead. And I'm having a drink with his killer. Now, I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you didn't. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? I knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. There's only one thing we know. One thing we're good at. I'm gonna be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
What are you waiting for? Fucking do it. Finish this, you fucking coward.
God. Wow. That was unsuspected. I thought he was just gonna shoot him. I know who this is. It's Leo.
I take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant to trigger it. Shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally, that pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here, right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, oh, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, do you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. Wanna sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is the 20%.
And what if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Classy Leo. Well, I guess the questions everyone asking now is, what happens next? Does Clay stay or does he leave? Talk to Donovan and Father James. Okay. I thought they would cut the credits there, but ooh. Where's my car? Oh, there it is. Oh my god.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over, done, finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just 'cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another
you,
Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's going to shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't going to be me, it's going to be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Hank. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California, leave all this behind, and just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go. And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy.
God, this lighting.
I'll be
so
seeing
weird.
You, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Bob.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
Damn! And more copyright music. Fuck it all. Now, where do we go down now? Oh, it's giving you the choice! Finally, the music is finished. Apparently we got two missions. I think this is a choice. One is to stay, drive to Plantation House, and one is to leave New Bordeaux. Sort of like a good and evil choice here. If we stay, we take control of the rackets and the districts. And if we leave, we go to California. Yeah, I'll leave. It's what Father James would have wanted. That's it. Dallas, Las Vegas, Oakland.
After Lincoln vanished, Vito Scaletta took over the city. I spit on Sal Marcano's grape one last time by actually doing what Marcano couldn't, finishing the casino. Now, 2 years later, Scaletta opened another casino, and then it was just an avalanche of development. Hotels, arenas, the new convention center. I mean, today everyone knows this place as the Las Vegas of the South, but the whole damn thing was built on bodies Lincoln Clay left behind with blood money he and his lieutenants stole from the mob. And Vito? He still lives in that penthouse at the top of Marcano's casino, looking out over the city he owns. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Lincoln made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that.
And credits. Nice. Well, at least it's no copyrighted music.
Let me ask you something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember at home, I
believe. What the fuck?
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do
with... What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Sit down and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assumed you would say that.
Don't fucking move!
How did he keep that down?
You're out of your mind.
Oh, I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you
them
never
to
get
see
away
that,
with this.
You stupid asshole. Because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you.
Oh.
And they're next. Gentlemen.
Get help. He's already dead. Wow. What an ending. But yeah, I actually enjoyed this game, despite what people say in the reviews. It really held its own weight when it came to the story and the cutscenes and the whole like interview sort of setup with these different characters. Father James was probably the biggest moving character in really personifying the story of Mafia 3. Donovan was like the main guy for information, and he was the driving force of Lincoln Clay's revenge to reach Marcano. And I think, you know, I think they did really well to establish a good story with Mafia 3. I like that they give you two choices: to either stay and take control of the city, or you leave completely and leave everything behind. I think I made the right choice, in my opinion. Down to the game itself, you know, it's decent. It's not good, but it's not bad either. It's definitely not terrible. It could have gone a lot better if they've taken it to the similar route as Mafia 2. The two good things that really outshined in Mafia 3, it's fluidity in the gameplay. It's, you know, despite the reports in performance issues during the release, which I experienced myself when this game came out the first few days, the frames was not only low, but it was limited to 30 FPS, which was pretty crappy in terms of our newer technology of gaming computers. I mean, there's really no excuse for locking the game's frames to 30 frames per second. That was a bit silly of them to do that. Which they quickly patched it the next few days to give you the options to do 60 FPS in unlimited, and that quickly regained my interest for the game and to finish the playthrough. So overall, Mafia 3, in my opinion, wasn't that bad. I really enjoyed the story gameplay. Not so much the heavy repetition of the side missions. That was probably the worst thing about this game. They could have done that part as a DLC expansion to Mafia 3, honestly. They could have just focused on the story as the biggest part of this this franchise. And they had it laid out for them in Mafia 2. I mean, all they had to do was just follow that. It was that simple for them, but I guess, you know, they wanted to be special. They wanted to make it unique in some way. But in all honesty, Mafia 3 is very easily comparable to Assassin's Creed Syndicate, where the structure there is very similar to how the gameplay works here in Mafia 3, that you have to, in order to get to the ultimate last boss, you have to go through a multitude of little bosses. In this game, there was a total of 6 lieutenants. And, you know, in order to kill these lieutenants, you'd have to work your way in all these repetitive assassinations, killings, stealing goods, you know, you name it. It's like, it's just, this could have been done as an expansion pack. And that's where Mafia 3 could have become more successful in that sense with additional content. And they could have just put their resources towards the main story gameplay and some multiplayer. And that's the next thing. I haven't seen any multiplayer for this game yet. Maybe after the credits it might show me some hints of it. But right now, I assume there is no multiplayer for Mafia 3. Which is worrying, considering the price tag for this game is nearly, what, like 50 bucks USD? Which is disappointing. I mean, for an average gamer that's interested in the Mafia franchise, you would be pretty disappointed if you looked at the reviews right now for this game, or even watch playthroughs like mine of Mafia 3. You would not be encouraged to buy it at that price for what you're paying is mainly just repetition and a few cutscenes and glorified pretty graphics, basically. And that's another thing that they kind of spent too much time on with Mafia 3. They put in a lot of emphasis in the world's graphics, the world's detail, the graphics with the characters and the cutscenes. You know, they could have put all that time and effort into refining the story a bit more instead of making the game look more pretty and sparkly and beautiful. But I gotta give it to them. You know, the game, in that respect, when it comes to detail and visuals and graphics, they did a hell of a job with Mafia 3. So props to Hangar 13 for doing that. I mean, they could have optimized it a lot better when this game came out. But yeah, guys, if you enjoyed watching all these Mafia 3 playthroughs all the way through to the end, hit that like, dislike button. Let me know what you guys think about the ending of this game. And subscribe if you want to see more content like Mafia 3, you know, any AAA content that's good for playthroughs or Let's Plays, you know, I'm happy to do that. Coming up in a few months will be Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm going to keep on top of that and hopefully get a copy and start playing through it. So it should be fun. All right, see you guys.